The ordeal is still not over for Nasser Ali, his wife and four children. One girl, Nadinor, is just 18 months old. They've been living in a city under bombardment by NATO for 5 months. There have been gun battles in the street outside their apartment for 5 days. Still, they are suffering. There's nothing in the taps and sporadic electricity. The only water hand-carried from a well.
Since a week ago, there is a real shortage of the essentials, in particular food, drinking water and fuel. And even if you need to go to the hospital, you face big problems.
Around Tripoli, people are queuing at tankers to fill up water containers. We headed through the city to find out what was causing the water stoppage. There is still sporadic gunfire, but most of it in celebration. Much of the city seemed less tense than in recent days. Women and children were out and about. Some food items were even on sale. Finally, we reached the water plant. Rumors have been circulating of sabotage or poisoning by Gaddafi forces. They're not true. I'm standing on top of the giant water tanks that normally supply the pipes of Tripoli. Right now, though, they are completely empty. Normally, they'd be resupplied through a series of reservoirs, the furthest one in the deep south of Libya. But there, they haven't had electricity for 45 days. There's no way to pump the water to the capital. Gunfire could be heard nearby as we spoke to one of those who must fix the problem.
If the group of engineers successfully restart the whole system, I don't think that it will take any longer than a week.
There is some help on its way. The first three ships have arrived from the island of Malta, carrying food, water and medical supplies. But so much more is needed here. James Bays, Al Jazeera, Tripoli.